Friends, today I am going to start the colligative properties. Although we have already discussed three colligative properties, one was relative lowering wave pressure, second was elevation boiling point, third we discussed depression in freezing point. Now fourth colligative property is the osmotic pressure. But before to discuss osmotic pressure, we should understand the term that is osmosis. So what is osmosis? You might have seen if we put some kismis in water, in some quantity water or milk, then you will find that after some time it swells. It swell kar jati hai. What is the reason behind it? Some water molecules have penetrated into the kismis, inside the kismis. That's why it swells. This process is known as osmosis. Basically, skin outer layer of the kismis that behaves as semi-permeable membrane. So water molecules penetrating into the inside the kismis through this semi-permeable membrane. This type of process known as osmosis. So how can we define osmosis? Osmosis may be defined as movement of solvent molecules. Through semi-permeable membrane, that is known as osmosis. We can understand in another way also. Let me take one beaker, and this beaker is divided in two compartments using a semi-permeable membrane. In one compartment, I put simple pure water. In other compartment, we take a solution. This side pure water, and this side is concentrated solution. After some time, we see that some level on the side of concentrated solution rises. Let us see, it is h centimeter. What happened? Basically, there is movement of solvent molecule from pure water side to the solution side. So this is osmosis. So rise h centimeter height on the side of concentrated solution, that is due to osmosis. That is due to movement of solvent molecule from pure water to the concentrated solution. If we take, instead of pure water, we take dilute solution, and other side we take little bit more concentrated solution. Again, water molecules will move from dilute solution side to the concentrated solution side. So osmosis may be defined as movement of solvent molecule from dilute solution to the concentrated solution. Okay. Now, one more point we can discuss. If I take again one container, and one side we take simple pure water, and other side I take concentrated solution, pure water, pure solution. So definitely there is movement of, and this is semi-permeable membrane, definitely there is movement of solvent molecule from pure water side to the solution side. But if we put some pressure on this side, अगर यहाँ पे हम एक्सटर्नल प्रेशर अप्लाई कर दें कुछ किसी भी तरह से हम यहाँ पर एक्सटर्नल प्रेशर अप्लाई करें और इतना प्रेशर अप्लाई करें सो दैट मूवमेंट ऑफ सॉल्वेंट मॉलिक्यूल फ्रॉम प्योर वाटर साइड टू द सॉल्यूशन साइड शुड स्टॉप. इफ वी पुट सम प्रेशर ऑन द सॉल्यूशन साइड सो दैट movement of solvent molecule stops to the concentric solution site. So this external pressure which has stopped the process of osmosis is known as osmotic pressure. So osmotic pressure may be defined as external pressure which is applied on the solution side so that no osmosis should take place. That is that external pressure is the osmotic pressure. So external pressure equal to osmotic pressure. This is one way of defining the osmotic pressure. In another way, we can also define, if I take simple thistle funnel, another alternative way to define osmotic pressure is this one. If I take a thistle funnel and thistle funnel mouth is tied with semipermeable membrane, now in the inverted form, I take some sugar solution into it, and this thistle funnel is placed into this thistle funnel in the inverted form containing sugar solution is placed into water. In this way, we can put thistle funnel in inverted form . So it is observed, water molecules enter through semipermeable membrane and level in the stem of thistle funnel. This is called a stem. Stem of thistle funnel increases by h centimeter. So due to increase in the height by h centimeter, a pressure it develops on the solution that is known as osmotic pressure. This hydrostatic pressure due to the increase in the height as centimeter, that is known as osmotic pressure. So osmotic pressure may be defined in the terms of hydrostatic pressure or in terms of external pressure. Now, what is the mathematical form? How can we calculate? How can we determine osmotic pressure of a solution? So osmotic pressure, so mathematically, mathematically, we can explain osmotic pressure. It was found that on the basis of different experiments that osmotic pressure is directly proportional to molar concentration of solution. If molar concentration denoted by C, so osmotic pressure denoted by pi, so osmotic pressure directly proportional to C, that is the molar concentration. Molar concentration means number of moles of solute present in 1 liter of solution. This is molar concentration. And it was also found osmotic pressure is directly proportional to the temperature. So we can say osmotic pressure is directly proportional to C into T, or we can say osmotic pressure is equal to R into Ct. R, where is proportionality constant, it is also known as solution constant, and its value equal to gas constant, that is 0.0821 liter atmosphere per Kelvin per mole. Or in terms of other value, 8.314 joule per Kelvin per mole. So we can say pi is equal to, means osmotic pressure equal to CRT, and C is the molar concentration, and C value can be written as number of moles divided by volume. And is the number of moles V, the volume of solution into RT. Or we can say pi V is equal to nRT. This relationship is known as Wathoff equation for dilute solution. By using this equation, we can calculate also molecular mass of non-volatile solute, and n can be written as mass of solute divided by molecular mass of solute into RT. So n can be written as, this is the, what is this, with the mass of solute in gram, capital M molecular mass of non-volatile solute. So by using this relationship, we can calculate the molecular mass of non-volatile solute. This is the mathematical relationship.